Right.
So the gold falls to its death, you know, hopefully quickly. So, but stay with me, because it's all a metaphor.
Yeah.
Right. Don't call
down,
Pina. Just stay with me. All of my sweet, beating heart, liberal friends. So,
that's all of
it. Watching too much Ben Shapiro. So this is the thing. What is Azazel? Azazel is an onomatopoetic word. It's a word like buzz. It means what it sounds like. Azazel. It's the mountain Azazel. Azazel is this force, if you would. It's like a negative force, but truth be told, it's the mountain of jagged edges. And why would we do that? Yes. After everything we've been talking about, where's the metaphor? So maybe some of you remember from last year, you can call it out. I'll give you like a fraction of a second. So why would that be the jagged edge? It's our sharp corners, it's our sharp edges.
Right, right.
The rough corner.
We're taught to polish everything out, right? Really. We're taught to take all of the ways in which you're sharp and polish them. That's important. It's part of refinement. Yet what if the very sharp edge is locked into your genius? Right, we learned from Isaiah that when God gives you genius, when God gives you talent, when God gives you a gift, right? God balances that gift or hides that gift. It's tzel Elokim, the shadow of that gift. Mm-hmm. Right? You're familiar with shadow work? The shadow of that gift is it's in disguise. And it's the opposite. It usually shows up as the opposite of that particular talent. And so Azazel, it's a sharp corner. But there's also a key that fits on that sharp corner perfectly, right? It fits right into the groove of that sharp corner. So that if you are, let's say, arrogant, right? They say that Moshe was a little bit arrogant. He was raised in a palace. He was mamash an aristocrat. You know, and he comes out to be with slaves, and then he's like slumming it, you know?
Yeah.
And they felt it. But Moshe's the humblest, the most humble of all of our biblical icons. He's the servant of God. He epitomizes humility. So if the gift is humility, it shows up as arrogance. And that's how it works. And so many of our sharp corners we want to hide. Just as we say, HaNeshamalach, my body is yours, God, right? All the places that I want to hide, I don't want people to see how big my hips are, how big my chin is, or, you know, I want to fix my nose, or whatever it is. I heard that. And so, we do the same thing with our personalities. I want to hide this frailty. I don't want you to see my shortcomings. Friends, there's a difference between faults and shortcomings. Shortcomings you can work with. Faults, sometimes they just don't change. And maybe that's okay. Maybe that's the way it's supposed to be. We're all born, the accident of birth, we're all born a little faulty. Why? Because it shows you exactly where your genius is. And friends, that's what Azazel is. It's not a devil. It's not a negative force in that it has a power over your genius. No, it just shows you where the genius is. It's a disguise. It's the smaller part of the challah. And so, if you would, I want you to hold up your hands for a moment. First, I want you to hold up your right hand. Because this is where we celebrate all of our genius and all of our sharp corners. Repeat after me. Baruch Atzaronoi. Friends, do you know what it is? Do you know what you're holding? Do you know your genius? Because I want you to think just for a moment. Think for a moment. Give me a little harmony, a little thinking music. Something in A minor. A minor thinking music. So put your hands down, but open your minds. I want you to turn to a neighbor. Just partner up for a second. Turn to your neighbor, and I want you to, the first word that comes to mind, the first adjective, the first genius, the first gift, just blurt it out to them. This is my genius. This is my gift. Own it.
Right. I was thinking exactly what you're talking
sharpness has a place. your life. So, if you dare, with the same partner, you can whisper. You can whisper this sharp edge, this frailty, this nuisance, this issue, this disguise, this hint of your genius. Do so at this time. I like that. Together we sweeten all that is unresolved.
Together we sweeten all that is unresolved.
This is the meaning of community, is that you're allowed to bring your sharp corners here, and you won't be turned away. As long as they don't, you know, cause anyone to bleed.
Yeah.
Mostly, we know each other. We know our corners. We know our grooves. And we love each other.
In spite of them, or maybe because.
And we know how to sweeten each other.
That's what I said. Because I said in spite, and then I corrected myself.
Thank you. So that your transgressions are recycled and become your mitzvah. Because nothing doesn't have a reason. There's nothing that doesn't have a purpose in this world. I said, the matzah becomes the, I know it's late, the matzah becomes the mitzvah merna. That's a tongue twister. And so, keep these up, and it smells so good. So keep this challah in your pocket and bring it with you. We'll do this ritual for Tasha. And to end the slichot service, we end with a little hint of Shabbos. We say l'chunu radanu. Come and let us end with song. The Chune Rani. The Chune Rani no dadu. Discovering that things that we used to call weaknesses are really strengths. So bless you to come to this realization in your own life, together, in your friendships, in your marriages, in your relationships, in your family, that it should, all of the weaknesses that show themselves should really become ways to bring you together into this.
There you go.
couple of days.
Parking.
No.